This is the Busch Wildlife Sanctuary in Jupiter, Florida, home to dozens of native species and dedicated to their protection and conservation. Living nearby, I'm super fortunate to be associated with these guys. I like to help them out whenever I can. Today, my good friend and executive director of the sanctuary, David Hitzig, will take us behind the scenes as we clean out some of the inhabitants' lodgings inside the Venomous Snake Room. As a pro bike rider, action sports announcer, and off-road adventurer, I'm always on the go. But for my true passion as a reptile breeder, I created my own sanctuary in South Florida. This is Kamp Kenan.
The snakes in here serve a couple of purposes. We're actually in the service area side. On the other side are the exhibits, where the public gets a chance to take a look at the animals, but we don't always take the animals off exhibit. So we've got some that are in here. But to make sure that everything is safe, we've got a closet which is here. The closet is locked. It's completely sealed so that nothing can escape if they escape their enclosure, so that we know that everything is good in here. Especially when you're dealing with venomous snakes, last thing you want to do is be surprised and get hit by a venomous snake.
Oh, forget it. Hey, you know, how'd this all start for you?
My mom was good friends with Bill Haas' wife at the time. And as a kid, I used to ride my bike to the Serpentarium, and I used to clean cages and everything else. You know, I learned a lot from Bill and everybody else who worked with him. And, you know, that's what really started me and my love for animals with snakes. The best part about it is my mom hated snakes.
Yeah.
So I got to hide them in the closet and piss her off whenever I could.
And you're still kind of in the closet.
I'm still in the closet.
There you go. Jesus,
you know?
I hear you. So. No, but that's really cool. I think it's neat. You know, so many people, it's interesting to see how people get their start.
For me, this has been something that I've been doing since I was a child. And at 52, I mean, you know, my hobby, my life's passion has turned out to be, you know, what I do for a living every day.
That's fantastic, man. So what do we got to do, bro?
All right, we'll get a snake stick here. The couple things I always like to have within reach, because whenever you're handling a venomous snake, you want to always make sure that you've got control. But something can always go awry. A snake can jump off the hook, a snake can go someplace else. So I always like to have a pair of tongs. I don't like handling snakes with tongs. I feel that it's a little bit more stressful for them. But I always like to know that the tongs are within reach for me. You know.
You're not a cowboy. There's a lot of cowboys out there.
Well, you know, let me tell you something. That's something else. People always ask, how many times have you been bitten by a venomous snake? And, you know, of course, I got to knock on wood. Professionally handling venomous snakes for 30 years, but, you know, from the time that I was in my teens, was handling venomous snakes and have never been bitten once.
Gotcha. Well, let's do that today.
I'm going to let you hold that.
I got the little.
Let's not make today the first.
No, I'm here with Kenan, so God only knows they're going to have it.
Oh, yeah.
This is an eastern diamondback rattlesnake. We call this little guy Aquafina, and that's because the person who found this snake managed to get it into a Aquafina water bottle.
It was actually in the bottle.
We couldn't get it out of the bottle. So we literally, he would crawl in and out of the bottle and eat on his own on a regular basis. And then one time he came out, grabbed a mouse, and his belly was too big and he couldn't climb back in. So we were finally able to take that bottle out. But it was probably a good year before he got to that
That's zone. Incredible, man.
Eastern diamondback rattlesnakes are the largest of the venomous snakes that are found in North America. And probably considered to be the most deadly because of their size and the sheer volume of venom that they can deliver in a single bite.
Yep.
It's not the most dangerous venom, but because of the size, you know, it makes
they hit hard.
Yes. So, when I handle the snakes, I always try to use the hook. Okay. What we're going to do, Kenan,
we're
going to open up that box, and we're going to go ahead and pick the snake up, and we're going to secure him right down in there. And then when you go to put this back up for just a second, when you go to do this, come down low in case the snake tries to strike out of there.
All right.
And you want to make sure that you've always got your eyesight on that.
Okay.
So that you don't end up getting hit, because this part of your body is vulnerable as well as what's up here.
Gotcha.
Okay. I've got one that screws and locks so that we know that he's good and secure in there. And then we can
safely clean.
This snake shed since the last time we were in here to clean. I always love this. We save these skins for a few reasons. We'll give it to the cats, and the cats love to play with it. They love the smell and the odor.
Really?
And
does it, in essence, does it kind of teach the cats what a snake smells like? Maybe it's something that they need to do to avoid snakes in the future? Or
I think they just like to play with it.
That's it. It's just
it's like catnip. It's
okay.
like, you know,
cool.
it's kitty crack, you know?
There you go.
All right. What we always look for is to make sure that everything is clean, make sure we got clean water, we'll clean this out. He'll go ahead and dump the shavings out.
Yeah, you got
our shavings in there.
See, this is a lot of fun for me because at my facility, I don't do a lot with snakes, and I certainly don't do much with venomous snakes. I also get a little verbal abuse with David, but that's okay, because if they're not making fun of you, they don't like you.
All joking aside, this is dangerous and dirty work that Dave and his staff take on every day here at the Busch Wildlife Sanctuary. They take great care and pride in their animals.
We want to make sure that we've got enough shavings in here
to cover the bottom.
Some people like aspen shavings. I end up using the pine shavings. It works good for us. It's absorbent. If the snake has to go to the bathroom, it helps absorb it, helps keep it clean, helps keep it dry. And it just is the method that we end up using. We've tried all different types of substrate, newspapers and things like that. This works the best for us.
Gotcha.
Okay, we're gonna go ahead and come back. There you go, real good. And one of the things that you did was really good is when you came down, you were low, protecting that strike zone that's there. Keep in mind there are ventilation holes that are here. It would be a weird thing for the snake to be able to get a fang through there, but not impossible.
Yeah, gotcha.
So one of the things that we like to make sure that we do is just keep your hands clear so that you're always protecting yourself, you're always thinking.
Gotcha.
The next thing we're going to take a look at is actually a copperhead that was brought into us.
You working at a sanctuary, you know, you deal a lot with fish and wildlife, so it's from your take, I mean, what do you think about hots for privates keeping hots? I mean, do you have an opinion on that?
Well, you know, it's tough because, you know, I've always had snakes and I've always had venomous snakes. But at the same time, I think that there needs to be a sense of responsibility. There's a lot of people who are just irresponsible. There's irresponsible dog owners and cat owners, and there's irresponsible reptile keepers.
Right.
So, you know, most certainly, I think it comes with a sense of responsibility, not only for ourselves, our safety, but the animals as well.
Cool.
This guy's a little bit smaller, so I'm gonna switch hooks.
How do you know someone's ready to come into the hot room?
In my history of running the sanctuary, we've only had, really, besides myself, there have only been three people that have ever worked with the venomous snakes. And I usually take on that responsibility because I don't want anybody else to get bitten. You gotta be careful. You definitely gotta be careful.
Look at that feisty little guy, huh? Now the copperhead here, This bite is not necessarily a lethal bite for a healthy adult, correct?
In most cases, if you're bitten by a copperhead, it's not going to be a fatal situation. However, anything is possible.
Right.
Okay. Keep in mind, just like people are allergic to bee stings, you get stung by a bee and brush it off. Well, next person gets stung by a bee and, you know, they're in the hospital. So, you know, you hate to use generalities, but the reality behind it is that, you know, somebody could end up dying.
Mm-hmm. Let me get a little squirt, mate. Thanks. I kind of have the best of both worlds. I mean, the sanctuary is so close to where I live. To me, this is the best way to have venomous snakes. They're someone else's. He gets the bills. So when you clean the, are you using the, what's that, chlorhexidine or something?
It's a disinfectant that we use. It's called Kenosol, which we use to go ahead and clean out all of the cages here in the sanctuary.
Again, these guys take the best care of their animals, and it really shows.
That's a real pretty snack.
Most of the pit vipers will ride a hook pretty well, but you'll find some that sometimes they just don't want to ride the hook at all.
You know, you being in the snake room, I've noticed it's kind of almost like a therapeutic thing for you, isn't it?
It gets me away from having to deal with everything else.
Phone calls.
You know, no one else is here. I know that I'm not supposed to play with my phone when I'm working with the venomous snakes. And it brings me back to the beginning of you know, what got me started in all of this.
Dave has handled venomous snakes for nearly four decades, this next guy still gives him and me a serious thrill.
Now this is my favorite, man.
Cobras have always fascinated me, so I always have had a cobra around.
Hold on, let's get the lid on this. This is such a cool animal.
And of course, keep in mind, you know, now we're really getting into one of the more dangerous animals that exist.
Well, these guys are just so, what I notice about the elephants and the cobras is that they're just a high energy snake. They're very sinewy and they move around a lot. And you made that look very easy.
Oh, hold on. Yeah. Yeah, you don't fool around with those colors.
And again, a lot of it is, you know, is taking your time with things. Mm-hmm. I will tell you, there's a downside. The cobra eats and poops and eats and poops and destroys the cage and moves all around, and always, every time you go in here, you're never gonna find this cage not clean.
Gotcha. So they're just a higher maintenance animal that you gotta spend more time with.
Absolutely. And then we'll go ahead and just dump all
of them. Yeah, we'll get rid of all this. They're really an active hunter. You know, the cobra, just the behavior, the way they get defensive.
They're also big bluffers too. And you know, a lot of what they're doing, you know, you see the hood spreading and the lunging and the hissing. They're one of the best actors that are out there. And they're trying to create as much of an intimidation presence as they can to be left alone.
They do a good job.
Unfortunately, it often works the opposite way because it gets people more interested. And so often that's how people end up getting bitten.
Yeah, they get bitten. And also it's stressful on the animal.
A lot of people don't realize that snakes being venomous is not for self-defense. The venomous snakes are venomous because that's how they secure their prey.
Right.
The venom is used is their method of being able to capture and kill their prey.
Okay, here we go. This guy's faster. I'll let you handle the lid. Have you had this guy get out on you in here or what?
No, we have not.
Okay.
You know, that's the last thing that you want to have happen. But as the handler, you got to make sure that anybody else that's here observing is always going to be protected.
Gotcha.
You know, I will use you as the shield every time.
It's to protect Tom, our cameraman. Thanks, buddy. Oh, my Lord. Well, this is what it entails, folks, so if you're interested in snakes, if you want to learn more about them, you can always check out Busch Wildlife on the web. Don't forget to email or comment on any questions. I want to say thanks to David for dealing with me today, but actually he and I go way back now, and I'm always psyched to be in the hot room at the Busch Wildlife Sanctuary. We'll see you on another episode soon. Can we do something again?
It always takes longer for me to clean when Kenan's here.